school dragon boating. What comes to your mind when you think about dragon boating?
Dark.
Huh?
Dark skin.
Well,
muscular.
Muscular. Well, let me start off with when I was small, and whenever I think of dragon boat, I remember the first time I saw a race. It was quite a nice day when I was sitting at the Swan Lake in the middle of Hanoi, eating ice cream with my family. I just happened to see this race going on in Swan Lake with village guys all dressed up like old-time soldiers in boats that is very nicely decorated as if they are real dragons. And it's something to me that is always half a sport but also half a cultural performance. And it's never something to go on, a competition to go on it by its own. In the context of Vietnam, the way I see it, it's something always part of the cultural performance. But then I came to Singapore, and then the image totally crashed. Here is really a sport of really muscular guys, the V-shaped hulk with broad, wide shoulders, and really very tan skin, and sometimes short legs as well. Not that nice. And to me, it's, I really never get why people are so much into it. What's so fun about doing the same simple movement all the time? What's so fun about it? It's so boring. You're doing the same thing all over again, and it's so painful on the body. And it's not like you are developing your body in a very effective manner. You are only focusing on a few parts of the body, and you're so lopsided in that sense. But then I joined my committee, and one of my close colleagues was the team leader for the Dragon Boat team, and she keep pestering.